Hello, my beautiful people. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are watching your time over there. God bless you all in Jesus' name. Amen. Welcome you all, my subscriber, those who are watching, may God bless you. Those who like, who comment, may God bless you all in Jesus' name. I told you yesterday we are going to be coming back because this number, we have not finished it yet, so it's very interesting. So if you would like to watch, at the end you are going to learn something from it. You are going to see what God did for me and you today. Praise the living God. So the topic, don't forget the topic: what bring jealousy spirit to a man who is married, to a man who have a wife. So we stop at 22, which said that, and this water that causeth the cause shall go into the bowl to make their belly to swell, and they tied to rope, and the woman shall say amen. So what is he saying? He said now they were not teaching the woman what is going to say. The priest, that is the church they went to, like the head of the church, now is not telling the woman what is going to say after he make all those comments, what is going to say amen. Because why? Something is happening. So the husband, they want to confirm, because his jealousy spirit cannot just come like that except something happened. That was them, which is the Old Testament, what happened them. So when your wife slept with a man, so the man in the house knows, because why? Nobody is there. So that jealousy spirit is the one that make the husband to know that, okay, my wife have cheated. Because if a wife did not cheat, that jealousy spirit does not come. No. But immediately he did do it outside, because no witness, nobody is there. So that jealousy spirit is the one that will tell your husband, your wife has slept outside. So your husband will begin to be jealous of his wife and say something is wrong somewhere. Praise the Lord. So now we continue in 23. He said, and the priest shall write this curse in a book, and he shall blow them out with the bitter waters, and he shall cause the water to drink the bitter water that causeth the curse, and the water that causeth the curse shall enter into her and become bitter. So the woman now is going to drink the water. When he drink it, so when he drink it, it became bitter inside her. Verse 25, it said, then the priest shall take the jealousy offering out of the woman's hand, and shall wave the offering before the Lord, and offer it upon the altar. Verse 26, and the priest shall take an handful of the offering, even the memory thereof, and burn it up the altar, and afterward shall cause the woman to drink the water. Okay, the woman will not drink the water. Okay, and when he had made her to drink the water, then it shall come to pass that if she be defied and have done trespass against her husband, that the water that causeth the curse shall enter into her and become bitter, and her belly shall swell up. So, and her tithe shall root, and the woman shall be a curse among our people. And if the woman, be not defied, but be clean, then shall she be free, and shall conceive seed. So now, if the woman be free, that it did not do what they are saying, so the woman will not conceive a baby, will not have a baby. So, but if it is true, her belly will not be swelling, so it will not swell up. Then verse 29 said, this is the law of jealousy. When a wife goes aside to another instead of her husband and is defied, imagine. So this is the law that Jesus have with Moses then. So any woman who go outside and sleep with a man, so this jealousy spirit will come over his husband. So the husband will not notice, because that jealousy spirit is the one that will inform his husband. Like when the husband have that jealousy spirit, you say, no, my wife have slept outside, because nobody is there, no witness, according to the beginning of the reading, nobody is there. So now it will not take, as far they are Christian, so it will not take the woman to the priest. And there are some things that they are going to add to it that follow it, so they will not add it to it and go to that place. Praise the Lord. So verse 30 say, or when the spirit of jealousy cometh upon him, and he be jealous over his wife, and shall set the woman before the Lord, and the priest shall escort up upon her all this law, then shall the man be guiltless from iniquity, and this woman shall bear her iniquity. Imagine. So after them, that this woman is going to bear, the man will be free, because the man was not the one that went outside and sleep with a woman, but the woman did. So the man will be free. He will not be guilty, but the woman will face iniquity. He will face the pain. He will face everything. Everybody will, like, according to what we are reading, says everybody will go away from, people will go away from her. Her belly will now be swelling up. Imagine that. But if he did not do it, then he will, that for her belly to swell up, he will not conceive a baby, which is seed. He will not have a baby. Praise the Lord. So now, what are we learning here? What did Jesus change in this place? Because Jesus speak to Moses to give this law, that this is the law that we have. So you see, if this law was still existing now, many people could have been dead, as in dead people by now, my brothers and sisters. We are going to learn something here, because we are going to stop here. So if Jesus the Son of God did not come to die for us, we could have still be in this law. We as the women who is married, you sleeping outside, you think your husband did not know. You as a man sleeping outside, you think your wife is not there, because your wife is not there. Nobody is there. Nobody catch you. But when this spirit come over your wife or your husband, they will notice that something is wrong. All they need to do, take you to church. Not juju, please, take you to church. So now, what did Jesus do? Jesus came to change this law. That is why he died, he shed his blood for you. That is why now, what did the Bible now say? He said, if your wife fornicate, let's read it, the book of, let's quickly go to the book of. So praise the Lord. We are going to look what Matthew 5 verse 28, and we are going to read 32 also. Look at now, Jesus have came to change the law. Now no more you go and swear anymore or repeat after the priest. Now what Jesus says in Matthew 5 verse 28, he said, yet from 27 I read, he said, ye have heard that it was said by them of old time, thou shalt not commit adultery, but I said unto you that whosoever looketh on a woman to lust after her had committed adultery with her already in his heart. And if then, what did verse 32 said? He said, but I say unto you that whosoever shall put away his wife, serving from the cause of fornication, causeth her to commit adultery, and whosoever shall marry her that is divorced commit adultery. You see it? That is divorced commit adultery. Now there is no more, like, you will go, first of all, your husband, the jealousy spirit will not come, your husband will not take you to a pastor. Not like that now. So now Bible is telling you that whosoever that did it, except you want to leave your wife, what did first Corinthians said? Let's see, read what first Corinthians said. First Corinthians, let me be fast because of my time. Amen. So at that time, now you cannot put away your wife. You can't say your wife should go, or you don't want to marry again because he fornicates or because he commit adultery. No, that does not happen at that time. But what did Jesus came to do? Look at what he said in 1 Corinthians 7 verse 10. He said, and unto the married I commanded, yet not I, but the Lord, let not the wife depart from her husband, but and if she depart, let her remain unmarried or be reconciled to her husband, and let not the husband put away his wife. You see now, so he said, maybe for example, you are a woman, you commit adultery. Okay, if your husband don't want to forgive you, he leave you and go. If your husband don't want to forgive you, he said, no, you commit adultery, you must leave my house. Then you not leave. He said, you should remain unmarried. You will not marry another man. You will remain unmarried, except you and your husband be reconciled together. So, my brothers and sisters, you see, this our generation, God is so faithful. He has come to change many things for us today. I believe many people could have been a dead person, like especially women that who have a husband and go out and sleep with another man, and a man also who have a wife and went outside and sleep with another woman. So I want us to learn from this today, my brothers and sisters. Free away for adulteress, free away for fornication, free away for adultery. It is not good. If God gave you a husband, stay with your husband. So we thank God for what he came to change for us, because a lot of people could have been a dead person today if that what will happen in the olden days time continue this time. Like when your that spirit of jealousy come up over your husband, you begin to swear, the prince begin to use it to make a oath, to make a vow that if you really do it, you know, so your belly will begin to swell. So I thank God Almighty for saving us, and I hope we learn something. Please, you are a Christian sister, you are a Christian brother, wherever you are, maybe devil may use your own wife, want to do something, do not fall into it, sister. If you are a married woman, stay with your husband. Manage what God gives to you. Take what God gives to you. Don't go outside and be sleeping with your young boys. Don't go outside and be looking for man who has money. Even if your husband don't have money, stay with him. Also for a man, you marry a wife, even if your wife is not well educated the way you want, take it, stay with her. Stay with her until Christ will come. And I hope we are going to learn something, and I want you to appreciate God for what he has done. Because if not that Jesus Christ came to die, he sent his only begotten son to die for us, this is what we could have been following by now. A lot of people could have been a dead person. So, but Jesus came to change it. So I pray that may God help us in Jesus' name. Married men, this is for you. Learn now that you are still alive, because a time will come that you will say, I did not know. God have pity on us with this generation, like we really enjoy it, because there are some things that happened in olden days time that did not happen, that God came to die for and change for us now. So let us not misuse that privilege that God have given us. Let's stand for Christ. Let's serve him. Let's obey him. Let's follow the rules. Let's follow holiness and righteousness, so that on the last day we shall see him. And I pray, as you enjoy this study with me, may God Almighty put something in, use this word to import something in your life in the name of Jesus. Sister, if your husband offends you, if your husband does not give you money for you to go outside and look for another man that will give you, call your husband and say, honey, let's look for something to do. You know, please don't go and commit adultery. Don't go and commit fornication. Like, don't go and commit adultery, sister. Don't go and commit fornication because you need money. Please, sister. And as you do, God bless you. Repent. If you are one doing this, repent and give your life to Jesus. Because on that day, this world is going to judge you. This world is the one that is going to judge you on the last day. Amen. God bless you all. And I hope if you like it, give me a like and also comment. And as you do, God bless you all in Jesus' name. Love you all and a happy weekend to you all. Have a blessed weekend.